Hey my lovelies, welcome back to my channel. I hope you're all doing well today and welcome to my new subscribers. And if you're new, if you've just popped in to have a nosy, please consider to subscribe. Love to have you. So I'm doing a reading today that was requested by one of my subscribers, Lisa. It's actually a good topic. So it is, how can you guys set yourselves free from a toxic situation or a narcissist, you know? So we're gonna have a look at that. So these are the three cards that flew out for you guys. So for group one, we have the Tree of Wishes is calling your name. An almost forgotten wish will now come true. Okay, so that's for group one. For group two, release your inner rebel, be yourself and create your own universe. And for group three, we have the time for romance has come. See it as an opportunity for radiant life. Yeah, and by the way, Northern Isles, oh my God, my dog's been ill all day, so I've been cleaning up dog mess all day. It's been great. So take what resonates, leave what doesn't. Don't force anything. And if it's not your story, choose another pile. See you there. Hey, group one, so you chose the Tree of Wishes is calling your name. At the bottom it says, an almost forgotten wish will come true. Now, obviously, if you're in a situation like what we're doing now, there was something that you have forgotten that you may have been wishing for. Maybe I'm picking up with you guys, group one. You know, when you've gone through so much with someone, sometimes you sit there and you think to yourself, I'm better off on my own, or I don't believe in love anymore. That's what I'm picking up. It's like something you wanted, it's, you know, is about to come true. So let's have a look. So that's just those cards. I'm not going by those cards. These cards are just like a little message for you guys, okay? So let's have a look. I don't know whether to start with tarot. No, I want to look at your situation. I'm going to use these cards. So tell me, please, Spirit, about this toxic situation for group one. Tell me about the toxic situation for group one. Oh, my God. That's too many, Spirit. Whew. Okay, let's do that again. Tell me about the toxic situation, please, for group one. Jump into group one. Thank you. So we have, which came out, quite a few of these came out just now. So we've got cheating, habitual cheating, more heartache in the future. Then we've got physical abuse, whether it's hitting, grabbing or shoving, it's time to get away. Okay, so you're dealing with somebody that's literally really taking the utmost pee when it comes to being abusive. You know, fair enough, you've got the physical side of abuse, but then they're also cheating at the same time. I don't like this energy. I really don't like this energy, and I think I'm going to be like that with all of them now. Yep, look. Abuse, mental abuse, they gaslight you and also mix signals, okay? And then we have control. They do not like losing control due to fears of getting hurt. That's just BS, man. I hate that crap that people use as an excuse to abuse somebody else. I get really angry. Ugh. Anyway. Don't mind me, you might hear me mumbling a few times behind the camera, but okay. So we've got the overall story here for you guys, okay? So you're dealing with a lot of abuse, a lot of control. I mean, this is someone that's awful. Awful. Tell me more about this situation. I want to know more about the situation, you know, because then you know it's your pile. Page of Pentacles in reverse, Three of Wands in reverse, Seven of Wands in reverse, Two of Pentacles in reverse, and the Three of Pentacles and the Queen of Wands on the back of the deck, which is the overall energy here. Now, just bear with me, guys, okay? You could be dealing with someone that travels a lot. You know, they may go away on business trips and or go away for work, or, you know, boys weekend or girls weekend, whatever, because I forget, these are energies, guys, okay? So, you know, male, female, because I do have male viewers. So this person actually travels quite a lot. And you can't go with them. You're not allowed to go with them. That's what I'm hearing right now. And I've said it before about clipped wings. It's like, you're not allowed to do nothing. You're not allowed to have a life. You're not allowed to have friends. You're not allowed to work. You're not allowed to travel with this person. It's like you are, I mean, I'm getting quite emotional because I'm obviously picking up your group one's energy here. It's awful. You're restricted when it comes to finances as well. It's like you're stuck. You know what, guys? Look, I'm seeing something here. Trigger warning, okay? I'm really picking up something quite sensitive, okay, with this reading. You guys are whoever's watching this, it's like you've given up. It's like you're at this stage where, I mean, I keep looking at this picture right here. You know? And it's like you're at the stage of giving up, that you're like, what is the point? You know, what is the point? But I don't mean giving up on this person. I mean giving up on yourself. I hope you know where I'm going with this, but I've got to keep it. Even though my readings are for 18, and I will put that on the actual thing. The description. I can't remember what that was. The description to actually say, you know, 18 plus, because I'm seeing something quite serious here with you guys, and I really hope it hasn't got to that stage. You know, you're so overwhelmed by everything. You're so ungrounded as well. I mean, obviously, of course you're ungrounded. And Spirit is saying here, I know this is quite harsh with the Three of Pentacles in reverse. It's like Spirit saying you're not learning your lesson. It's like you keep repeating the same mistakes here. And I feel like for some of you, maybe you've tried to leave this person and they come crawling back and they suck you back in again. And this is why the Three of Pentacles is in reverse here. You've not learned your lesson. It's like you're a shell of yourself. This is you. This is your energy, the Queen of Wands. You've just got to find that energy again. You know, you've got to be the Queen of Wands. She is someone who's very strong, okay? Very independent, confident, beautiful, powerful. You know, she sticks up for herself or people around her as well. And this is the energy that you need to embrace here, which is Leo, Aries, Sagittarius. And we've got Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. Right, now let's have a look how you can escape this situation. So Spirit, tell me, I've had to write this down because it was so long. how can Group 1 set themselves free from this situation? How can they set themselves free from the situation, please? I am actually going to clarify that card at the end, okay? How can Group 1 set themselves free from the situation? you need to break up with this person. That's what spirit is saying. Tell me about the Three of Swords. You need to end this. This person has broken your heart too many times. Wheel of Fortune, you're dealing with a karmic here. And the thing is, I'm also seeing here with the wheel, okay, what is happening here is this person is so bad for you. I wonder if devil's going to come out. Look, bad for you. Tower. This person causes so many tower moments in your life, okay? They are destructive. They are... I can't swear. But, you know, just add something on the end of that. So, with this person here, this energy, they bring about so much misfortune, okay? And until you split up with this person, you walk away, you end this connection and you cut ties with this person, your fortune is going to turn, you know, for the better. You're going to be sitting on top of this wheel, you know? I feel like this is a really horrible person. This is a serious, toxic, devil, karmic. Tell me, please, about the Wheel of Fortune. How can they escape this situation, please, Spirit? Goodness me. Spirit is saying here, literally with these three cards right here, you need to face the truth. You need to accept the truth, okay? This is all about truth, the Ace of Swords. You need to be true to yourself. And also when this comes out, the tarot reader is usually correct in what they're saying. I do like to add that bit. You need to find mental clarity here. Tell me about the Wheel of Fortune. You know, if you can accept what this is, you know, it's easier said than done. As I said before, I've been in this situation myself many years ago. I was young and dumb. Sometimes I want to go back and slap myself across the head. But, you know, I mean, I put up with 10 years of abuse by somebody. I mean, it's been 20 odd years now. Say 22 years now, thank God, but you never get over it. And you, anyway, tell me about the Wheel of Fortune, please, Spirit, and this Ace of Swords. You need to get away from this person. I just feel like Spirit is really desperate here to get through to you. I mean, it could be that you're really fearful of this person. If this person is actually they have all these traits right there, you know, it's must be scary. And I feel like this person's cut you off from everybody as well, so maybe you're not even in touch with family members. I feel like you're a loner. You've got nobody. And I mean, and how dare you do that to the Queen of Wands? So we have the Moon. Tell me about the Moon. Tell me about the Moon. I think I know what the Moon's saying here. Yeah, you've got to make a decision, okay? Judgment. You need to listen to your intuition, okay? Listen to your dreams as well. I feel like maybe your spirit guides are trying to connect with you through your dreams. But it's like the Moon is like a nightmare as well. This person promises you that, you know, they're going to change, they're going to do this, they're going to do that. But Spirit is saying it's just an illusion. You can see the truth for what it is here. You know, and judgment. This person makes you feel guilty. You shouldn't have to feel guilty. That's why you stay. And you know it's all an illusion. You know it's not going to be true. You know they're full of lies here with the Moon. It's like you're not seeing the bigger picture here. And judgment as well, you know, that's a final decision. That's you making a decision here and following through. that Spirit's saying you've got to end it with the Three of Swords. Still not getting enough information though. Tell me, Spirit, how can Group One escape this toxic situation? What can they do to get out of this? Page of Wands. Tell me more about the Page of Wands. How can I get out of this? Four of Wands again. Tell me about the Page of Wands and Four of Wands. Tell me more. What are the Four of Wands? Okay. Then we have the Seven of Pentacles, Six of Pentacles, and Six of Swords. Two of Swords. Very confused. So guys, you could be married to this person, okay? Some of you, you may have even thought this person was your twin flame. Spirit, oh, I can see what Spirit's saying here. You've got to be clever here, guys, okay? You've got to wait, bide your time here with the Seven of Pentacles. The reason Spirit is saying bide your time here, you need to maybe, I know it's not terrible actually, because where I said about you not having no finances, you know, I feel like that's where their control is here. And it's like you, so there's two scenarios here I'm seeing what Spirit is saying, okay? Basically, you need to choose yourself with the Lovers. It doesn't matter whether that's there with the Four of Wands, okay? You need to start choosing yourself, and you need to maybe start investigating, trying to find a way to get out of this situation. If it is funds that's holding you back here, Spirit is actually saying, bide your time, okay? You need to start taking from this person, but in a very clever way, okay, with the Six of Pentacles. You know, this is equal give and take. This is like, sometimes I see it as taking from somebody else, you know, taking the mick. So what I'm seeing here is bide your time and slowly start putting money away is what I'm seeing. You know, start hiding funds from this person if that's the way you need to get out, because you've got no one to help you. If you were to do this, Spirit is saying, you know, you've got the Six of Swords here. This is you moving into calmer waters, okay? Peaceful time ahead of you. And then the Two of Swords, you know, you are very confused and you're very conflicted, because it could be you feel like you may be stealing. You're scared that this, you know, you may get caught here. Tell me about the Six of Pentacles. Also, the other scenario is, I nearly forgot there. I don't even know whether I said it, but anyway. With the Six of Pentacles, it could be that Spirit wants you to reach out to someone that you're close to ask for help, because the Six of Pentacles is help from other people. Let me clarify that. Tell me about the Six of Pentacles. Wow. Knight of Swords. Okay. Tell me about the Six of Pentacles. Tell me about six. Oh, actually, hang on, guys. So we've got Leo, Aries, Sagittarius again. We've got Gemini. We have Pisces. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Okay. So tell me about the Six of Pentacles. Who is this Knight of Swords? Who's this Knight of Swords? there's someone here, okay, that is, feels very protective over you. This could be a sibling or a friend that you work with. You know, for some of you, you may have a job, and the thing is, you may have to give all your finances over to this controlling person, okay? And this is where, with the Page of Wands, because I keep being drawn to the Page of Wands, that is like a study, and that's a job, that's, you know. So as I'm seeing this here with you guys, what you need to do, if you have got like a little job, sometimes we have to make up stories, you know, to you know, for your benefit. And in this situation, I would say 100% do it. So maybe like come up with an idea of putting a little bit of money away, you know, maybe you're not earning so much, something like that. There's something here that you need to do to get yourself out of this situation. It is money. But there is somebody here, the Knight of Swords. This is somebody that is willing to take a risk here to help you. We've got the Ace of Pentacles, which is beautiful. You know, this is someone that is very fast thinking, okay? You know, usually it's a man, so this could be a male in your life, but this is someone that is very, very fast thinking and very protective. Now, that could be who Spirit is saying to you, you need to reach out and you need to ask for help, because I'm telling you, the Knight of Swords will charge in. They don't care. They could be reckless. They'll take charge and they'll help you with this new beginning here, which is, look at this, we've got two work cards here, you know. This person works hard for their money, okay? They're doing very well for themselves financially here. And they're willing to help you here with the Ace of Pentacles. This is might be them helping you get a new job, or giving you some funds to move away, because this is moving somewhere else, you know. Start, look at that, hang on. This person, I want me to talk. Okay, so where was I? So yeah, this is someone that can help you set up somewhere else, you know, move. This could be someone that even owns their own business and is willing to give you a chance, you know, some work here. You know, there is somebody in your life that you can actually reach out to. So you've got two scenarios here that you can either start putting money away slowly, or you need to reach out to this Knight of Swords right here, who's going to give you a brand new beginning, is going to give you a second chance here. Tell me about the Ace of Pentacles and the Eight of Pentacles, please, for group one. Do you know what's very weird as well, group one? I've started your reading and my throat's really hurting, so I don't know whether this person has a habit of grabbing you by your throat. Like, literally, my windpipe feels very bruised right now. Nine of Wands. This is somebody that is very courageable. You know, they've got a lot of courage, and this literally does clarify, you know, the Knight of Swords. This is literally, Spirit is saying this is a test of courage for you as well. You know, are you going to be persistent? Are you going to move forward? Are you going to start again here? You know, we're giving you, Spirit saying we're giving you another chance here. This is abundance here. But you need to be persistent. You need to have that courage to leave. Talk about the Nine of Wands. Look at this. The Sun. The World. The Empress. Look at this. You are the Empress, as well as you came out as the Queen of Wands as well. This is healing. If you can persist, if you can have the courage to leave, you are going to heal from this, and you're going to be living a life that is going to make you very, very happy, okay, and content. But you just need to end this chapter, okay? You need to find that courage and end it. Close the door, throw away the key. don't look back. You've got a whole new world out there waiting for you. You know, you may want to travel. You may want to start something online, you know, like a business or something here. But this is completing a lesson and a goal here with this world card. This is, I feel like this is your karma. This can be ancestral karma as well. And like I said at the beginning, Spirit is saying you are not learning your lesson. And until you get out of this situation, things are never going to get better here, guys, okay? And I'm seeing you guys giving up. And that's what's really worrying me here with you, you group one. Please don't give up, okay? You know, you're the divine feminine. You still, you've come through this. And to become the empress, you have to go through so much crap in life to be the empress. And this is you guys here. You know, some of you may be parents. You know, that might be why you're worried about leaving as well. But even after all this, you're still going to be the empress. You're not bitter. You're not nasty. You don't take it out on other people. You've got so much empathy and love for people. And that's what that is what's really beautiful about you guys. So I want to clarify that tree. Tell me about the tree of wishes. What was this wish, Spirit? Tell me about the tree of wishes. Two cups. Tell me about this tree of wishes. Oh, wow. Nine of cups. Guys, look, I know this is not... Well, maybe... Look, you've come out again. But then again, I think this might be... somebody else. You've literally got the wish card, okay, fulfillment, happiness, success, and then you've got the two of cups, which is love, commitment, soulmate. So there was something you had forgotten about, and I did say that at the beginning. I'm sure I said that at the beginning. I mean, my brain's all over the place today. Yes, I did. Where I said, where you guys, I'm picking up the energy of, you're like, I don't believe in love no more. I give up on that. Ever meeting that person. You know, you may not even be thinking about love at the moment, but there was a time in your life where you were innocent before all this took over and affected you in the way that it did. You forgot about this person that's supposed to be with you. Who is the Queen of Wands? Energies, guys. It can be male, you know, someone who's confident, strong, friendly, that is very protective. And this is so weird. We've literally got the wish card, and it says that an almost forgotten wish will now come true. I mean, come on, we can't make this up, can we, really? So no, you may not be wanting that right now. You may be at this stage of where you're, that you don't trust anybody, which is totally understandable, but there is a soulmate here for you, and this person I feel like would, hang on, let's have a look, let's be nosy. Tell me about the two of cups. I feel like this person will really look after you and be very protective with that Queen of Wands. The Star. Oh, wow. This person's going to heal you. Ace of Cups, guys. Come on. Look at that. You may not want love. This is what I'm saying. But there is someone here for you, okay? Which is that you manifested a long time ago and forgot about, okay? Because the Star is manifestation, it's dreams coming true, all your hopes and wishes. This is the wish card. We've got the wish card, we've got three wishes here. You made this wish a long time ago, I feel like, before you met this person, and you may have thought that this was your twin flame, because we did have the twin flame card, or your soulmate, and it's turned out to be a karmic. We've got the Ace of Cups, which is the divine is giving you this second chance at love, marriage, commitment, and healing. That's beautiful, guys. Okay, let's get some oracle cards for you guys. Group one, please, Spirit. Patience. I accept that everything happens in divine order, and I said that you have to be patient. You have to, you know, be one step ahead of this person. Health. I honor the physical vessel and that enshrines my soul. So guys, you need to look after your health here because this is affecting you. And I did say that with that card. You may have stopped eating. You know, when I'm stressed, I lose weight. Help sometimes. Denial. I acknowledge my fear, but I replace it with the insight of awareness. And that's the problem right here. It's like, I've said this through the reading, it's like you don't want to face it. You don't want to face the truth. And I feel like that is just fear. And don't get me wrong, getting out of a situation like this is very scary. I know. So let's have a look what angels are saying. Moonlighting. You can start working on your dream career part-time while keeping your other job to pay the bills. Soon your dream career will take flight and fully support you. Now, it could also be what I said here with this moonlighting, that you may need to do something when it comes to funds here. But it also could be that I said this person, whoever this is, that you need to reach out to ask for help, who is very giving here, is going to give you, you know, help you with your career, maybe help you get a job. And then we have block out distractions. Your life purpose and other priorities need your undivided attention. So it's time for you to take charge of your schedule and working environment by turning off electronics and avoiding anyone or anything that distracts you from what's important. You already know that these distractions are, know what these distractions are, and you have the power to responsibly block them out. And that's the thing. And don't think it's just electronics. I do believe it's this energy here. Let's get a message from the angels as well. So we have Archangel Uriel. Your emotions are healing, which enables you to open to greater love. I will help you release anger and unforgiveness from your heart and mind. Now that's very weird. Because on the back of the deck here, we also have forgiveness. I acknowledge that I'm harboring resentment blocks the flow of love. So, you know, you need to maybe, you don't have to forgive this person, but you need to maybe forgive yourself. But Uriel is watching over you guys. And then we have Astara, you deserve the best. Reach for the stars with your dreams and desires and don't compromise. And that reminds me of the star card, that right there. Wow. Look on the back of the deck here, guys. We've got a happy move to a new home or place of employment is in the works. This movement will usher in positive new energy, and that's exactly what I'm seeing down here. Okay. You're about to go into, hopefully, or you've already got him, you know, maybe this has already happened to you. The Six of Swords, which is peace. You know? So, I'll put that back. Hang on. So let's get a couple of these as well. A win-win outcome is forecast. I can't read. Your dreams need a practical plan. Okay. So, you know, you need to be practical. And then we have conclusions are within reach. Yeah. I feel like you're about there, guys. Maybe you've already started hiding a bit of money away, you know, maybe you've reached out to this person to help you. So anyway, ask a question, guys, and let's see what spirit says. So ask a question or think of your question. So for group one, please, spirit. Oh, come on. So on the back we have you bet. Okay. So whatever you ask, spirit saying you bet. So group one, I'm going to leave it there. Please, please take care of yourselves, okay? And I hope this reading, for, you know, has brought you some sort of peace here. So, yeah, please look after yourselves. So much love, guys. Create group two. So if you chose release your inner rebel, be yourself and create your own universe. So with this card right here for you guys, it is basically what it's saying. You need to release that inner rebel. You need to start fighting back. You know, stick up for yourself more. So but I'll clarify this card right at the end. But first of all, I'm going to get the energy of the person you're dealing with, and then we'll go from there, okay? So tell me about group two. Who are they dealing with, spirit here? Group two. Tell me about this toxic situation. Bad motives. Opportunities. They're taking advantage of the circumstances. Trust your gut. Very handsome in that picture, but not very good thing at the bottom. So tell me about this toxic situation that group two is dealing with. Secrets, okay. This is like a theme. Settling. They'd rather settle than to break up because it's not exactly bad, but not great either. Oh, okay. This is someone that takes the pee. This, by the looks of it, from what I'm getting from just these two cards, I'm going to get a few more. Somebody's just basically staying for, you know, the comfort. It could be money. It could be, you know, you've got assets together and it's just convenient. It's just comfortable. They can't be bothered, you know. And it could be this person don't even work. Because it's saying there, this person's taking advantage of the circumstances here. Tell me more for group two, please. Abuse, mental abuse, they gaslight you, yep, or send you mixed signals. And this is the thing right here. And it's like, look, this has come out twice. Intuition. It is your intuition. Or are you overthinking a situation? Okay. From what I'm getting here for you guys, group two, is that this energy here is taking advantage of you. But, you know, I don't feel like there is physical abuse with this pile, okay? But it is still abuse. So it's basically when you maybe try and point out something to them, like, you know, do you love me? And then they'll be like, oh, no, you know, don't be silly. Or they'll come back with an answer with, well, do you love me? I hate when people do that. I hate that where you ask a question and they come back, counteract it with a question, avoiding the answer. And then they confuse you so much. Talk from experience here, as you can tell, most probably, because I'm getting really fiery. They confuse you so much that you think that you're going crazy, and then like you think to yourself, well, what was the question that I asked, because I don't remember. And this is what this person is doing to you. And it's out of, I'm really strongly picking up financial. This is financial. This is all I'm saying right now. Let's have a look. Tell me more, please, spirit, about this toxic situation. So I'm going to do the toxic situation first, then find out how you can get out of the situation. So tell me more about this toxic situation that group two is in, please. So we have the Six of Pentacles in reverse. Wow, I have gotten the right way. And tell me more about the Six of Pentacles in reverse. And this is what I'm saying. This person, why am I hearing thief? It's like, even though they may not be stealing from you, but it's like they are, if you know what I mean. It's, it's like you make so much effort with this person. You give this person all the time. It's you giving, not the other way around. There's no receiving here. It's giving. And it's like, you're not getting a reward back. You're not getting nothing back from this person. Like, you're not even getting any. I feel like this person doesn't even give you a hug or tell you how beautiful you are or handsome. You know, we've got male viewers. That kind of thing is what I'm picking up here. Tell me about Six of Pentacles in reverse. Whew. Tell me about Six of Pentacles in reverse, please, spirit. Moon, the Devil, what a surprise. It really doesn't surprise me at all. And the Five of Pentacles and the Eight of Wands. Oh, my goodness me. I feel drained from just group one. Oh, this person is full of BS, guys, full of BS. They, you know, the Moon is like my gaslighting card as well, okay? It's all about illusions. It's all about confusion. It's also about your intuition as well, you know? Maybe you're not really in tune with your intuition. Maybe you're, you know, even though your intuition is screaming at you right now, this is wrong, this is not right, but you're ignoring it, okay? You're dealing with someone who's very greedy here, and this is someone who is all about me. It's me, myself, and I, not you, me. That's all I keep hearing. Very selfish, toxic energy here, and they mess with your mind with the Devil here, guys, okay? They mess with your mind with the Moon as well. It's person's full of lies, and all they've done is cause despair for you. You know, if anything, you're actually struggling yourself here, because it's like you're giving all to this person here with the Five of Pentacles, and it's like your finances have started taking a really big hit here. It's like you're providing for this person, not the other way around. There's no support here. This person is cold towards you, distant, emotionally unavailable is what I'm picking up as well. And your mental health is starting to suffer now. This person is very codependent on you here. Very lazy, very codependent. So we've got Pisces and Capricorn here, guys. Tell me about the Devil. You're dealing with someone very toxic, okay? Eight of Pentacles, the Six of Swords, yep, Six of Swords, Five of Swords. This person bullies you into freaking, they've got so much, look at this, Seven of freaking Swords as well. This person, and you guys have come out of the Empress, group one came out as an Empress, you've come out as the Divine Feminine here as well. You guys are too nice. This is the problem. The Empress is very nice. You know, she's very caring. She's very loving. You've got this nurturing nature about you, okay? I feel like you're like this person's mother as well. So this person could have mummy issues. Sorry, I'm being quite harsh in these readings, but but this person has so much control, even over your mobile phone, over your... say your Insta, your Facebook, your whatever. They have total control over what you do online, okay? This is controlling. They watch you, they spy on you, but I feel like they even do it in front of your face. There's some kind of gossip surrounding you as well, like, but very malicious, like spiteful, like, haha, like, you know, she or he's an idiot, like, I've got it really cushy over here, and this is the gossip that's going around about you, okay? We've also got the Five of Swords, which is, this is bullying. This is somebody that is bullying you, mentally abusing you as well. This is my mental abuse, my bullying card. Controlling, you know, you work very hard for your coins here, you know, but you're the only one that works. I'm picking up you're the only one that actually brings in the income here, not them. And if they do work, you don't receive anything from this person. It's like you have to pay all the bills. It's like this person's loving life while you're struggling. And you've tried to talk to this person to smooth things over, to make things easier for you, but they're just not listening here. They are so sly. They are so freaking sly. With the Seven of Swords right here. This is somebody that is a liar, a cheat. They steal. They're sneaky. They want to get away with something. And they may have been getting away with it for a very long time. But I feel like that's why that released that inner rebel now. You need to literally just... I feel like you're going to explode. Group two. Tell me about the Seven of Swords. Yeah, look at this. Seven of Swords. Tell me about Seven of Swords. And yeah, Seven of Swords for the spirit. What do we have there? Eight of Cups and the Three of Pentacles in reverse. Okay. You're so scared of moving on. This is your problem. You're so fearful of moving on. And Spirit's saying you're not learning your lesson. You're just literally letting this person do this to you, Gucci. And I know it sounds like I'm really having a go at you. And I'm not, but Spirit's saying you're not learning your lesson. When are you going to learn your lesson? When are you going to wake up and see that what is actually holding you back here? This person is taking advantage of you. For some of you, this person could actually be a cheat as well. There could be third parties involved here. Tell me about this Three of Swords. Tower. Four of Cups and Temperance. And the Page of Wands. You're feeling unfulfilled. Spirit is saying here, this person brings no balance, no harmony into your life here. You feel so unfulfilled. It's like, literally, this person keeps breaking your heart, you know. You know they're not emotionally available. You know that they don't actually love you. This is one-sided, guys, okay? Tell me about the Tower. Queen of Pentacles, yep, there you go, freaking heck, whatever. You know, you could be dealing with a narcissist here, okay? And this is the thing with a narcissist, they are so good at what they do, what they say. Oh my God, it's like, I've dealt with one, and I'm telling you, they're hard to beat at times. I know it's not competition, but I hope you know what I mean. This is... So we do have Sagittarius and we do have Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn as well, guys. Right, okay. So this person here with the Queen of Pentacles that's in reverse. This person's very shallow. They're very ungrounded. Okay, very greedy. Person, I'm just hearing gluttony. I hope I got that right. Gluttony, yeah. It's one of the seven deadly sins. Or is it ten deadly sins? Oh, I don't bloody know. But I know some of them. Yeah. But yeah, that's what I'm hearing, gluttony with this person. I feel like they overindulge as well with food. So they could be, they may have put on a lot of weight because they're so lazy. Because they do nothing with themselves. Let's find out how you can escape this person, okay? So tell me, please, for group two, how can they set themselves free from this toxic situation? Three of Cups. Tell me about the Three of Cups. How can they set themselves free, please, Rip? I mean, your cards are flying out, guys. Queen of Wands. Tell me about the Three of Cups. She is a rebel, the Queen of Wands, okay? Male, female. Then we've got the release your inner rebel right here, okay? Now, the Queen of Wands is somebody that, when you pee her off, you're going to know about it, okay? So you guys could be fire signs, Leo, Aries, Sagittarius here. You need to find that inner rebel within you here, and you need to stand up for yourself here. don't let this person push you around no more. Tell me about the Three of Cups. You know, I'm picking up with the Three of Cups here that you have a good supportive friendship group. You know, you've got people around you that will support you. But I feel like this is more, you know, maybe you don't want to escape this person, but you just want them to respect you and to get off their backside and do something about this situation here. And I feel like that's where your rebel needs to come out, guys. Your Queen of Wands here, who's strong, independent, successful, fiery. Okay. Two of Wands in reverse. Yeah, you're so scared of change. Spirit keeps saying you're scared of change. You're scared of moving on. Tell me, Spirit, why is Group 2 fearful of moving on? Because you feel stuck. You're not stuck, guys. The Hangman, even though he's hanging there, you're not actually stuck. The Hangman can get down at any time and move on. You're wasting time. Spirit is saying with the Hangman, stop wasting time. You know, Spirit is saying that this person has no interest in you. So what? Why are you? We've got the Lovers, we've got the Fool, we've got the King of Cups, and then we've got the Four of Pentacles. You won't let go, guys. You're not letting go. You love this person. You want this person to romance you. You want this person to show you love, but it's not happening here. You know, you're hoping, it's like you're holding on, Group 2, for them to notice you, choose you, you know, love you. You want a new beginning with this person. You want a fresh start. You want them to, you know, respect you. And the King of Cups is, maybe it was like that at the beginning for you too. This person used to show you love and then they got comfortable. You know, because the King of Cups is somebody that's in love. But this also could be your energy as well, where, you know, you love this person so deeply. This is why you are holding on, because of the love that you have for this person, even though you know they're doing you wrong. So until you... I don't know. I mean, I ask Spirit why you're scared, because I feel like you're thinking to yourself that you're not going to get another chance with someone here, you know, a new beginning, finding that special someone. But that's just fear. So we have Gemini, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces as well. So Spirit, tell me please, what can Group 2 do to escape this situation? What can they do? What should they do? What can they do? Oh my God, all right. So we have the Ten of Cups. Okay. Tell me more about the Ten of Cups. What can they do? I've got the Ten of Cups. Spirit is saying here with the Three of Wands, guys, I know it's really harsh to hear, and maybe you obviously don't want to hear it if you're still very much in love with this person, but Spirit is saying here, you know, you want your happily ever after with this person, but this person isn't it, guys, okay? You're yearning for something that's not there. This person's, you know, the death is all about change, and Spirit saying you have to change, you know, you may have to end this situation here. You know, Spirit has literally just blatantly said, end it. You may have a family with this person. That could be why you're holding on as well. Tell me about the death. You know, this is big changes that are happening. Big changes that you may need to, you know, you may need to make big changes when it comes to your, yeah. Hmm. spirit is saying this person is just going to keep piling on their problems on you. You're going to keep having to carry the weight of everything, you know, the responsibility of everything, the family, if you've got family, you know, the bills. This is what spirit is saying. Unless you end it, this is what is going to keep continuing here. Spirit is saying you've got a passionate new beginning right here with the Ace of Wands. This is a fresh start, a new job, a new romance. It's feeling excited for the future here. Tell me about the Ace of Wands. But you feel trapped. Spirit's saying that you're in your head too much. You're overthinking things too much. You're scared. You're scaring yourself, basically, with the Eight of Swords. You're not trapped, even with the Eight of Swords. Like I said about the Hangman, you can get down from that tree. You can walk off. With the Eight of Swords, you bet that fell off. That's why I turn it over. So whatever you're thinking, it says you bet. you know, with the Eight of Swords, you're not trapped. You can walk through those swords. But you are overthinking everything. It's like you're your own worst enemy, group two. It's this fear. This is all about fear, that the Eight of Swords. And I'm picking up, it's like you don't want to be alone. So you're just accepting this situation for what it is because you're so fearful of being on your own. I feel like you are not confident within yourself because this is what this person's done to you. You came out as the Queen of Wands. She's stunning, handsome, beautiful. Inside out, you've got this energy about you with the Queen of Wands. But you're just not seeing it. So what advice would you give group two, please, Spirit? The Four of Swords in reverse. Spirit wants you to find mental clarity here with the Four of Swords in reverse, okay? It's like you're I feel like you're gonna go for an awakening here with this card. Tell me about the okay, I didn't even ask. Yeah, you're gonna go for an awakening and your finances is fine. Even if it isn't at the moment, you're going to be fine, guys. Look at this, generational wealth on the back of the deck. There's somebody in your future here that will love you for you, okay? There is marriage and commitment here, a second chance to do this again with someone. And this is going to bring about generational wealth here. You know, you are very successful at the moment. Yes, you will be single once you leave this person. Your money's not going to suffer at all here. You're going to be loving life here. I mean, come on, you've got an exciting new beginning right here. You just got to take that leap of faith with the fall, okay? You've got to go into that, even though you don't know where you're going. It's just take that leap of faith. You need to, the rebel I'm seeing here is, it's all about telling this person no. That may actually shock them, you know. So, yeah, that's your advice there about trying to get out of this situation. Unless you accept it, group two, and overthink things, you will not be able to move forward. There's nothing holding you back here, is what Spirit's saying. This is your own personal fear. Tell me about the Release Your Inner Rebel card, please, Spirit, for group two. Queen of Swords. Yeah, there you go. Spirit's saying here, even though you have a lot of memories with this person, you know, some could have been good, some could have been bad, you know, and you're trying to get back the good, but the good is not coming back. This person keeps hurting you and you're repressing that pain. You're not letting that pain out. It's like you just keep burying it, burying it, burying it. And Spirit wants you to literally, with the Queen of Swords, is to use your head, because she's very intelligent, the Queen of Swords, okay? You can see through this person, even though they may think that you're stupid. You are not stupid, because the Queen of Swords, she's not stupid, she's clever. And this is where you need to start becoming more cleverer than this person here, you know. You need to be honest with this person, and you need to protect yourself, because the Queen of Swords usually has the sword up, you know. She's protecting herself, and you are suffering with so much sadness, group two. So do you have Gemini, Libra, Aquarius? So much sadness, so much repressed pain. And you need to release that. That's clarifying that card. Release that inner rebel. And I feel like that's what's going to happen. You're literally just going to explode like a lion. So, you know, we're good. We do have two lions. Okay? So let's get some oracle cards for you guys. So for group two, spirit. Guilt. I release any beliefs that no longer assist my soul's growth. And this is the devil energy here. They guilt you. They make you feel bad. And then you're sucked back in again. You know, that's the gaslighting as well, guys. You know, you're a good person, like I said. You guys are the Empress. I mean, beautiful inside and out. And this is where the people, the devil energy, takes advantage of the divine feminine, you know. Adversity. I accept that challenges are the best way to learn. Exactly. This is like a learning curve for you guys. Then we've got balance. I bring a state of perfect harmony into my world, and I do so without judgment. And this is what you need to do. You need to restore balance and peace. I am a being of love, and I release all negative energy. That's what spirit wants for you. Let's get a message from the angels to you guys. That wanted to come out. Opal, your children on earth and in heaven are happy and well, cared for by God and the angels. You know, that could be the problem here. We did have the Empress. She is a mother or a father. And it could be this is why you're trying to hold the family together. You know, you don't want to break up the family. You don't want a divorce. You don't, you know. But sometimes we've got to do what's good for us, you know, and your children. Because children learn. They pick up everything. They're like sponges. I remember when my kids were little, you could never have a conversation in front of them because they'd just blow it out, you know, something private. Patience. Now is the time to learn, study and gather information. Enjoy being a student because in the future you will synthesize your knowledge into action. So maybe you want to go back to school, you know, maybe you want to study something else here. And then we have Isabella. I love that name. Yes, the timing is right for this new venture. A happy outcome follows your positive expectations, okay? So, you know, Spirit's saying the timing is right, you know, time to do something about this energy right here, group two. Then we have Quiet Retreat. It's time to disconnect from the outer world so that you can discern and process your true thoughts and feelings from the inner world. Create this quiet time for yourself and you have more clarity about what to do next. And that is what this has been saying. This is what Spirit has been saying. You need to, you will be finding clarity. You are going to be finding clarity here, but it's taking time because you're in this energy of being so fearful, you know. On the back of the deck, we have obstacles and blocks are lifted. All your good personal work and your positive energy shift have overcome previous obstacles and blocks are lifted away. You will now experience progress and forward movement with your projects. Stay centered in gratitude to ensure that your flow of abundance continues. There you go, guys. I'm just going to grab these. Get a couple of these moon cards for you guys. Balance spirituality and practicality. Full moon in Pisces. Now I said there may be some kind of awakening here for you guys, okay? A win-win outcome is forecast. So ask a question, guys, or think of a question, and let's see what Spirit says, even though that card fell over, but let's have a look, okay? Surely not. Ask again. Okay, ask again, guys. Maybe rephrase it. I'm gonna do a bit of a weird one. All right. Very doubtful. So that's like basically two no's. No. Anyway, so group two, I'm going to leave it there, okay? If you like this video, please hit like. I appreciate you guys, and you have a wonderful day or evening. And much love, guys. Hey, group three. So if you chose the time for romance has come, see it as an opportunity for a radiant life. Now, it could be new romance will be coming into your life, but I'm going to clarify this right at the end of the reading, okay? Because I want to have a look at the energy that you're dealing with, you know, the situation that you're in. So Spirit, tell me about this toxic person that group three is dealing with. So we've got cheating, online flirting, social media or dating sites. This manipulator will make you feel special by telling you what you want to hear. Manipulation. Okay. Jeez. That's too many. Do that again. Oh my goodness. Okay. Manipulation again. They refuse to commit to anything or give you a straight answer. Sneaky behavior, criminal mind. They could engage in some criminal activity, theft, fraud, or using illegal drugs. Wow, this person, oh my god, look at this. I am taking them now. Look at this from you guys. We've got manipulation again. Purposely takes a long time to respond. Are they ghost you to place doubt in your mind? Okay, and then we've got manipulation again. They twist the facts by alerting reality with lies or misstatements in order to confuse you. Then we have sneaky. Seduction. They are trying to seduce you. Hopefully it's not just physical. And then we've got cheating. An emotional connection with someone else. And then we've got cheating. The opportunity is this cheating heart will have sex with anyone that is willing. So group three, you're dealing with a serial cheat here, someone that's non-committal as well, okay? I feel like the energy of the Knight of Wands, where they're in and out, they've got no staying power, they can't commit to anything here, okay? But this person, you know, you may be in a full relationship with this person, but they're not actually committed to you, okay? There's so much sneaky behaviour and manipulation here with you. And it's like they may go out and then you try and contact them and it's like this ghost in here. Or it could be for some of you, you may not even hear from them for a week and then they'll come up with some BS here. It's because they're off having fun with someone else, you know. I'm trying to say fun, but you know what I mean. So tell me more about this toxic. So I'm going to find out about the toxic situation, then find out how you can escape this situation, okay? So tell me more about this toxic. Okay, didn't even ask. Wow, you have a lot of sleepless nights. You wait up for this person to contact you. This person gives you so much anxiety, okay? So much stress. Because you don't know where they are, when they're going to reach out again, or whether they want to be with you. Tell me more, please, Spirit, about this toxic situation for group three. I mean, I feel like you've shed more tears than you have laughter with this person, group three. We've got the Nine of Pentacles. Yeah, that's the problem right here. You feel like we've got strife as well. You feel like you're single. You know, with some of you, this could be like you want a commitment with this person, but they're not willing to commit to you. But they, you know, they're full of BS, basically. But even though you're in a relationship with this person, you're not actually in a relationship with this person. Like I said, you feel like you're single because there is competition. There is outside competition that this person is bringing into the relationship here. Tell me about the Five of Wands. You know, this is strife, judgment. Six of Pentacles, Six of Cups, sorry, and the Four of Wands. Some of you may be married to this person, but they're still literally not emotionally available. They're just not there. It's like I'm seeing you guys on your own all the time. It's like you are living like a single person here. They never want to do anything with you. They never want to go anywhere with you. They never want to sit and talk with you. And it's like when they are at home, they're not actually emotionally available because they're constantly on their freaking phone and, you know, and communicating with other people. This person's very damaged inside. It's like they look for validation in other women or men because there's something freaking missing from them. You know, and you're at this stage where you want this person to maybe make a decision about the relationship here, whether you want them to commit to you here, okay? You share, you know, you do share a lot of happy memories with this person, but I feel like that is just one-sided, guys. That's your memories, that's your nostalgia that's there, you know, you're reminiscing about this person. You want this person to commit to you fully, you know, you're hoping they're going to give you marriage here. You feel like this is your twin flame, but guys, I really do feel like this is a false twin flame. This is not real. You know, you want the family, the home life, the security, marriage, and all you're getting is disaster after disaster after letdown, letdown. Wow. Tell me about the tower, please. Person has brought nothing but disruption and destruction to your life. It's like you've got no inner peace. Seven of Cups. Yeah, look, this person is reckless when it comes to your heart, guys. Okay, they're very reckless. They don't care. This is someone that could be a bully. Someone that's very harsh and brutal at times. And I feel like this person may even throw it in your face, group three, that they're doing this. Or it's like you're not worthy. I feel like this person puts you down, puts you inside your head here, that you start doubting yourself, you know. You know this person has multiple options. This is what the disaster is here. They have so many options. It's not just one, it's seven or more here. And this has caused you to be so depressed, so low within yourself. We do have the Eight and the Nine of Swords here. This is crappy energy right here. All right, let's have a look. Tell me, Spirit, how can Group 3 get out of this toxic situation that they're in? How can they get out of this? What can they do? King of Swords, okay, use your head. Spirit is saying here, you're intelligent. So hang on a minute. We only have air sign in this reading. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius so far. You need to admit to yourself, Spirit is saying, you need to face the truth here with the Five of Swords and the Page of Swords, that this person goes online, because this is an online card, okay? It's like spying, it's social media here. And you need to admit to yourself that this person is abusing you. It doesn't matter whether they're not physically hitting you, but they are abusing you, they manipulate you, they confuse you, you know? And Spirit wants you to protect yourself. You know, the King of Swords, he's very intelligent, you know. Spirit wants you to detach yourself. Be honest with yourself, because you are somebody that has morals. This person doesn't. You do. You know, you respect yourself, Group 3. But the problem is, you need to detach yourself, Spirit is saying, from this situation here, like the emotions. Detach yourself from those emotions and then look at it in a logical way. You know, even write a list of what this person, like their pros and their cons, and I bet the cons are actually the worst. You know, I don't know why I heard a list, but that might be an idea there, you know, what this person does for you. And I bet you can't even fill up that side of it. It will be all the negative on the other side of the page. You know, you've caught this person getting up to no good online. You know that something is going on. You feel it. Spirit is telling you that there's no one's going to win in this situation here, especially not you, Group 3. Nobody is winning here. There is no happy outcome here. And sorry to say that, you know, I am on this one. I do my readings because, you know, we can't sugarcoat things. What's the bloody point? Okay, look about the Lovers. Okay, tell me about the Lovers. Gemini, strong air sign. Okay, tell me about. Oh my God, what is going on with you guys today? Group two was the same. It was like literally everything was flying out. Oh, okay. I did put them right. Yeah. You've got here a brand new beginning, guys. Oh my goodness. That is so weird. I just said you've got this brand new beginning here, and then I looked over there because I forgot about your card, and it says a time for romance has come. If you can admit defeat, okay, and walk away here with the Five of Swords, there is somebody there here for you guys. Okay, you may not want anyone right now, but there's somebody that chooses you, that wants to be with you, that wants to have that connection and that relationship with you. And this is somebody that wants to give to you as well as you give to them. They want it to be equal. This is a brand new beginning here, okay? This is, you know, starting a life with someone, a brand new life, the Ace of Pentacles. This is what Spirit is saying. Here you go. This is what I'm giving you right now. I mean, look at the way the hand is coming out of the sky there. Take this new beginning, Spirit is saying. There's an equal partnership here. You know, it's mutual love. This is a foundation that you can both build here together. It's something solid that you can build together, which is a life with this person, a commitment. But Spirit, you're not telling me how that... Tell me, how can they get out of this situation? I do feel like it is that you've got to face the truth here, guys. You've got the Emperor. Tell me about this Emperor. We've got loss of pleasure. Yeah, you know, the Emperor here. Oh, wow. What did I say at the beginning of the reading? This reminds me of the Knight of Wands, and the Knight of Wands is right there. Spirit is saying to you here, okay, this is a false divine masculine here. Okay, you need to face facts. Spirit is saying that this person abuses their power. Okay, they are very like much, so much in their ego that they think they're just like wonderful. But really, Spirit is saying this person's very weak when it comes to the opposite sex. It's like they can't control themselves. They think with their doodah in their underwear, okay? it's just a polite way of putting it that way. So yeah, you've got to face these facts that this person is not going to give you the emotional support or the commitment that you're looking for, Group 3. You know, this person makes you feel unloved. You know, you're shedding a lot of tears here. There's so many tears in this reading. Because you do, this person... But this is how they work. This is how I'm picking up this energy, is that... They're the type of people that, you know, you could be dealing with a narcissist, okay? But these are the type of people... How can I explain this energy to you? They just have a way about them that convinces you to stay, you know. It's like when they know that you're pulling away, it love bombing. And then it's like, this is where the confusion is. It's like one minute they're there and the next minute they're not there. They're off again. They're off. So what advice would you give, Group Free Spirit? So Spirit is saying you need to face facts, you need to accept this for what it is, you know, and when you do, here comes your new romance here, your new beginning. What advice would you give Group 3, Spirit, please? Look at that, face the truth, Spirit is saying, okay, look at this, Ten of Cups, this is lovely. You've got somebody watching you. Somebody that likes you. There may be someone you know online, okay? This person likes you. They see you as their happily ever after. It's like this person, whoever this is, wants the Ten of Cups with you. So they watch you. You may not even be aware of this, okay? And when the Ace of Swords comes out, Spirit says the tarot reader is telling the truth. But Spirit wants you to face the truth, okay? This is mental clarity here. This is something being revealed to you. It could be Spirit's going to reveal it to you. It could be where I've just done the reading that you're like, oh my God, okay, yeah, okay. So this is being revealed to you right now of what you need to do to get out of this situation. You need to face the fact that this person I don't even know what to call this person. I keep hearing Casanova. That's what I keep hearing. So let's clarify this time for romance has come, please, Spirit. Tell me about the time for romance has come for group three. We've got the Four of Cups. And then, wow, what did I say? Somebody is spying on you guys. Somebody's got their eye on you. And this someone is waiting very patiently for their chance with you. They keep looking to see whether you're with this person or not, whether you've broken up. But it's like they get their hopes up and then all of a sudden you get back with this person. This is what I'm seeing, a lot of backwards and forwards with your energy here, group three. And this energy is watching you, gets really excited, and then all of a sudden they're like, oh my God, I've got to wait again, you know. Yeah, this. Tell me a bit more about this time for romance has come. This person, might be someone you know, someone from your past even, because we do have the Six of Cups there. It's someone that may want a reconciliation. It may have been a childhood relationship when you were younger. This person still watches you. We've got the there's someone that's got feelings for you guys. Somebody that's got feelings for you. Look, they want to communicate this with you. We've even got the Ten of Pentacles here, guys. This is generational wealth. This is growing old together, having a family together, leaving a legacy to your children and then their children. And this person really wants to communicate this with you, that they find you very attractive. But there's a conflicted message right here. This person is going to reveal to you, okay, with the Page of Cups. They are going to tell you that they've got feelings for you. They're just waiting for the right opportunity for this energy again, the Knight of Wands, to bog off. So then they have that chance with you. Because every time they go to approach you, they may have even tried to let you know in subtle ways. But every time they want to tell you that they've got feelings for you, this Knight of Wands comes running back in. And it's like, this is a karmic you're dealing with. You need to get rid of this karmic, guys. But then everybody's got free will. You do what you need to do. So we do have Aries, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, Leo, Aries, Sagittarius, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. I said that already. So let's have a look at some oracle cards for you guys, okay? So for group three, please, Spirit. We have loneliness. Oh, look at that. What did I see? I know that I am never alone, but this is the problem. You feel so lonely, and this is what I'm saying here. It's like you are single, even though you are in a relationship with this person, but you're not. And Spirit wants you to know you're not alone, okay? Group three. Judgment. Didn't we get judgment? Yes, we did get judgment right there. It's come out again. I understand that everyone has their own unique path and challenges, and that's the problem there. You need to choose a path that's right for you, okay? This is a decision that you need to make, group three, for yourself. Friendship. I understand that a friend is in my life for a reason. And then this is what I said. This could be somebody that is a friend, okay? Somebody you may not talk to so much. You may have added each other on Facebook or whatever, Insta, whatever you've got recently. And I feel like this is someone that you knew when you were younger, you know, innocent. This wasn't something serious. And this person really, really wants to communicate with you, but they can't because of the Knight of Wands. So let's get an angel message for you guys. So we have, it is safe for you to receive The more you allow yourself to receive, the more resources you have available to share with others. Open your arms to receive and be the conduit for good coming to you and through you as it blesses the world. God, I can't even freaking read. This is what Spirit's saying. It's safe for you to receive. Maybe you feel like you don't deserve to be happy or be in love. You know, you are all up in your... You are very depressed at the moment, group three. You are the Eight of Swords, very confused, feeling stuck, feeling like maybe should I give this person more time? Are they going to change their mind? Spirit's saying they're not going to change, guys. Donations, tithing, and charitable work. Giving joyfully to the organisations and people who spiritually support and inspire you. And know that your generosity will be returned to you manyfold in miraculous ways. The time, supplies, money or other resources you donate will ensure that your positive energy multiplies. Look, it could be that you do donate to charity and stuff. And the more you do, the more... You know, the universe is going to give back to you guys, okay? So let's get some more angel messages for group three, please, Spirit. So we do have Desiree. No conditions aren't favourable right now. Wait or look into other options and ask the angels to help guide and comfort you. So the angel Desiree is saying that the conditions aren't favourable right now. Wait. Or look for other options. And this is what she is saying. She is saying this is not favourable for you. Look elsewhere. Then we've got Rosetta. You have a gift for working with young people. And your divine purpose involves helping, teaching or parenting children. So you could be a carer. You could be a teacher. You could be someone that, you know, maybe a nurse or a doctor here that works with children. Or something to do with charity here. You're a very giving person here, guys. And this is why Spirit is going to start rewarding you for everything that you do for other people. Yvonne, you have a special bond with animals. Your pets on earth and in heaven are watched over by angels. So you could be a vet as well, guys. There's something here that you are very, very, very unique. Group three. Lila. Spend time alone in nature, meditating about your desires and intentions. Ask the angels to help you gain a positive perspective. So you may need to meditate more, guys, and maybe get out in nature, put a bit of meditation music on. That usually helps. So let's get some moon cards for you. We have prosperity lies ahead, new moon in Taurus. You are very close to achieving your goal, okay? And then we have a new romantic cycle begins. Oh my God, you really can't make this stuff up. You literally got that. I'm pointing at that card. Then you've got the new romantic cycle begins, and then you've got the lovers there with somebody that's got feelings for you. This is not the person here, guys, okay? I'm seeing that very, very clearly. So if you're thinking, well, maybe it is this energy, maybe they're going to change their mind, maybe they're going to come around and grow up. No, they're not. Okay, they're not. So think of a question and see what Spirit says. Think of one or ask for one. Or ask out loud, should I say. Looks like yes. Okay. Looks like yes. So it looks like a yes. For what Spirit's saying. So group three, I'm going to leave it there, okay? If you like this reading, please hit like, and you have a lovely day or evening wherever you guys are. And I'll see you soon, guys. Much love.